take you from Causeway Street right inside North Station, TD Garden. Lots of black and gold, but we're always looking for this. Yes, the Boston chapter of the Kraken Nation. The proud colors of Jared McCann and Philip Grubauer. And we are good to go. First ever meeting between these two teams. Let's check out the goaltenders tonight. Chris Drieger will make his 12th appearance of the season for Seattle. He has 3 wins. He looks to get himself back on track. He's had a tough time with injuries and COVID this season. Linus Ullmark was in goal Sunday in Dallas, and everyone to a man, not very good for Boston. He started the game, did not finish. They lost it 6-1, but he's had a very good season. This will be his 24th appearance. He has 15 wins. Dave Hakstol loses Will Borgen to COVID tonight. He'll be replaced by Cale Fleury, and Fleury will play alongside Brother Hayden. Snoqualmie Casino Sportsbook opening faceoff. Sit back and enjoy this one from Boston, Massachusetts. The Kraken clear it all the way back down. Third game of 4 straight on the road for Seattle, coming off an overtime win in Pittsburgh on Thursday and that tough loss Sunday afternoon in New York. Bruce Cassidy, 2020 Jack Adams Trophy, NHL's Coach of the Year, led Boston to the Stanley Cup in 2019, and their loss in 7 games in this building to the St. Louis Blues. Off the faceoff, Vince Dunn will hunt it down. Here's Boston native Ryan Donato out to center. Far side, Jonas Donskoy. Donato right through the blue and out. Held in by Seattle's Alex Wenberg. Let go by Donskoy for the ex-Bruin. Jeremy Lauzon. He'll get a deep red by Mike Riley for Taylor Hall. And the Bruins are out to center ice. This is their final game before the All-Star break. They clear it in. Vince Dunn back on it. Moved along. Wenberg to the flank. There's Donato. He'll take it back. Just inside his own stripe. Fling it across for Lauzon. Seattle rolls a change up front. The Yanni Gord line comes out. It'll be Gord alongside Mason Appleton and Kelly Yarncroke, who's back in the lineup. Yarncroke out of the corner, Gord in back of the goal, indirect pass, shot taken by Giordano, rockets wide. Adam Larson for Gord in back of the goal. He'll take it to the outside of Charlie McAvoy, clear it all the way around. Here comes Larson. Larson moves in, sets up Gord. He's hounded by Matt Grizzlick, who has the puck, and the Bruins attempt to get it out and do. Starting lines will be brought to you by Emerald Queen Casino shortly at the top of your screen. You can take a look at the line combinations and defense pairings. Gord now sends it back to Chris Drieger. Vince Dunn will quarterback from there. The McCann line comes out. Jared McCann, Jordan Eberle, Marcus Johansson, a former Bruin, Brad Marchand goes across for Riley. Right between the legs of Craig Smith. He's got it. Smith over the line. Now Brandon Carlo. It deflects off a stick. Bergeron. It goes off a body. Oh, Vince Dunn out in front. Smith winds it up. Here's Patrice Bergeron. His shot off a stick off Marchand. Out in front. Out of the corner. And in back of the goal, Vince Dunn almost gave it away. A second chance. McCann gets it out. 2-on-1 with Marcus Johansson as McCann lost his edge. And the Bruins dodge a bullet. Bergeron. Now Marchand over the line, going wide, off a stick, off the glass, captured by Bergeron. He's got it through the blue and out, all the way across now. Vaakanainen with a shot off the side of the goal. He attempts to get to it, the young rookie. It goes out in front as Seattle defends the house, and Hayden Fleury is out to center ice. He's marked by 3. He'll clear it all the way back in. He'll get after it himself as Seattle changes to the boards. The Bruins clear it through center. Mark Giordano will take it back. Out to center ice. Curtis Lazar, 20 in the black. Through the center ice zone, Seattle on the march. Riley Shane is taken down, and Seattle gets the power play.
Boston 81, minor penalty tripping.
Riley Sheahan does a good job just keeping his legs moving. After he dumps his puck, he's trying to go in. And you see right here, just chip off the boards, trying to get in on a play there. If he doesn't move his feet, doesn't fight through the check. You're not going to get this call. Good for him, and Seattle has a good opportunity to take the lead here early in the first on a power play.
So Anton Bleed in the box, and Seattle, who is 2 out of 19 in the last 5 with their power play. Muckleshoot Casino power play, shot by Giordano, broken up by Bergeron. He's won a Selke Trophy 4 times, top defensive forward. Marchand will get to it. Outstanding penalty killer throughout his career. Played along the boards, Marchand will keep it deep. McCann, Giordano, Johansson, Eberle, Gord on the ice for Dave Hextall. Giordano now walks it out to center. Sends it back for Jordan Eberle. He'll take it through the center zone, a handoff for Johansson. Now McCann, Johansson chipped wide. Eberle out in front. Tomasz Nosek gets to it. He'll dump it all the way back in Seattle territory. Just about 4 minutes gone in the opening period. John Forsland, JT Brown, Jen Mueller tonight from TD Garden. Here's Donato. Ryan Donato to the wall. Moves in on Pakkinen, plays it out of the corner. Wenberg is there for the Kraken. McAvoy, Curtis Lazar off the boards and out. Seattle down to 58 seconds left in this power play. Vince Dunn orchestrates from his own territory. Right on the money for Donato. He'll try and rim it in. Donato played his college hockey at Harvard. His dad coaches there, and they play tonight against Boston College. Dunn, Wenberg. Now Vince Dunn to the half boards. Alexander Wenberg advances, peels away from the pressure of McAvoy. Here's Dunn at the line. Now Wenberg. He'll dangle in, a shot taken off Donato. Stopped by Ullmark. Linus Ullmark on the spot. Now Wenberg back again for Dunn. Guarded up top by Charlie Coyle. Geeky zings it across for Wenberg. He'll go skate to stick. Play it out of the corner now. Lay it back for Dunn. Dunn with a wrister through traffic. It's blocked. Recaptured by Seattle. Here's Wenberg. He'll look it over. He'll draw it away from Charlie Coyle. Move it across. Good stick by Jake DeBrusk. And it goes out of play.
Seattle had a couple good looks on their power play. This one off the breakout. They don't waste time setting it up. Eberle goes right to the front of the net, just tips it wide, and you're going to see Donato in front gets a tip on it and a second whack at that puck, but getting pucks to the net and finding opportunities on the power play.
Anton Bleed has 4 seconds left to serve. Riley Sheahan, Colin Blackwell, was born in Lawrence, Massachusetts, just outside Boston. Mason Appleton on this forward line. Forked out of the zone by Nosek. This is his first season with Boston. Many good years in Vegas. Now Hayden Fleury. Paired on defense with brother Kale. Nosek resets it. Even terms on the ice. Even terms where it counts. David Pastrnak. Lead pass at the line. Nosek for Taylor Hall. Hall takes it in. Back to the point, Brandon Carlo. He'll play it to the outside by Nosek. Pastrnak in the corner. He'll grind it up top, look around. Great goal scorer. He's hounded by Appleton, and it comes back out to center. David Pastrnak, a lead feed for Taylor Hall, who was the MVP in the NHL a couple of years ago in New Jersey. Blackwell off a skate. There's Hall. What a stop by Drieger. Outstanding save. Now Mike Riley with a shot tipped wide. Nosek out in front. Drieger scrambles back on Pastrnak. And the Kraken get out of dodge. Eberle to the far flank. It's Johansson. Eberle has McCann in front. Off Ullmark. He gets it back. Jordan Eberle does. But it's broken up by Taylor Hall. And the Bruins take a breath. Here's Pastrnak at the line. Pestered by Giordano. Eberle moves it across for Marcus Johansson. Swiftly through center. In the zone to the outside of Matt Grizzlick. All the way around for Giordano. He'll snap it in on a cycle. Johansson. Given a shove by Bergeron. Marchand out to center. Craig Smith is broken up. McAvoy drops it off. Marchand. McAvoy in front. Smith. What a save by Drieger twice. The last one on Marchand. Chris Drieger. 3 outstanding saves early. Now McAvoy moved along for Craig Smith. McAvoy in charge. A handoff. Grizzlick below the line. Marchand. Smith with a shot. It rifles off Giordano. All the way back for Grizzlick. To the outside. Left there by Smith. Defended by Larson. Picked up by Gord. And the Kraken will get it out. Jordan Eberle. Hounded by Matt Grizzlick. At the line. Marchand had it. He lost it. Vince Dunn takes it away from Patrice Bergeron. Larson kissed along the wall that time. by Oscar Steen. It comes out to center. Charlie Coyle. Jake DeBrusk. Now Steen. Now Coyle to the outside. Good stick check by Gord. Coyle goes deep. Sends it all the way around. Appleton on the gallop. Good pinch by Pakkanainen. Now Dunn. Nice pass for Adam Larson. And the Kraken are free out to center. You're looking at Mason Appleton. Over the line, Yanni Gord. What a goal he scored Sunday to tie the game late on a power play with an extra attacker. Now Appleton moves it across outside the line. Captured by Jeremy Lauzon. And a reset for Seattle. Kelly Yarncroke, a late scratch Sunday, goes to the bench on a change. 8 minutes gone, period one. John, JT, and Jen here in Boston. It goes off the stick of Donskoy. Olmark will melt it down. We'll do some business. And handling all the business so far is Seattle's number 60. Chris Drieger has been called on early, and he has been stellar here in Boston. So we'll do some business shortly, JT. Just stick around. This comes in on the goaltender, Olmark. Linus Olmark, first season in Boston, big free agent contract. Stephen Fogarty, muscled off it by Vince Dunn. He'll play it around for Riley Sheahan, back out to center ice. 11:25 left in the opening period. Goalless start in Boston. Pakkanainen, read by Dunn, he's got it. He'll pump it in front off Olmark, it's available, but Taylor Hall gets to it now. Curtis Lazar skates it out to the center zone, helped out by Hall, who stumbles, and the Kraken take over again. Sheahan for Blackwell. Colin Blackwell goes to work. A little cut on Derek Forbert. Back to the point. Played by Giordano. Giordano to the slot. There's Blackwell. He'll send it to an open corner. Nosek is on it for Boston. Sealed off a bit by Geeky. A pinch by Adam Larson. Larson out of the corner. Forbert has control. Pounded by two checkers, Blackwell and Geeky. Boston gets out of that. David Pastrnak through the center ice zone. Marked by three, one of those. Giordano, good poke check. It comes out to center by McAvoy, all the way down. No icing, no break. Face off in Seattle ice.
Seattle just seems like they're trying to get their legs out from underneath them. Boston's had a couple of good shifts with zone time in there, making Drieger make a bunch of good saves. They do have a little bit of pressure down in the offensive zone, but they got to get their legs moving a little bit faster right now.
Good start for Chris. Faceoff win, Boston. McAvoy, point to point. Matt Grizzlick, Charlie McAvoy, he'll dangle. Guarded by Johansson. A tight turn by Marchand. One-timer McAvoy off a stick. Bergeron captures the puck. Plays it in back of the goal. Walks it this way for Marchand. He'll saucer across now for Grizzlick. Popping out Marchand again. Matt Grizzlick downstairs. Fanned on by Smith. Charlie McAvoy takes over. McAvoy between the wickets of Bergeron. Marchand, McAvoy. Good movement here by Boston. It gets to the wall. Marchand will hustle across. It's dug out by Jared McCann. Elevated out to center. McAvoy sees it. He turns it over. McCann, Eberle, through the middle. He has McCann, a penalty upcoming against Boston as it goes high as McCann was taken down. 9:44 left to go in the opening period. Seattle will get their second power play here in Boston because of this. Jared McCann upset through the middle by Charlie McAvoy. Welcome back. A big night for Ryan Donato. The Xfinity powerful connection tonight. His family. Ryan born here. Oh, that's a great look. You know he's a go-getter from day one, right? There he is with his dad, Teddy. Ted Donato played 9 seasons in Boston. Beautiful family. He was born in 96. Went to Harvard. Drafted by the Bruins. 56th overall in 2014. His brother, you see Jack Donato in that photo there. There's Ryan at Harvard. And a rich history. But when you grow up around the game, and you grew up in a sports family with your dad's great NFL history, it's just something that you have from day one, right? Johansson now moves it off a stick. We'll get to your point, JT, if we get a break here. McAvoy in the box, second Muckleshoot Casino power play for Seattle. Giordano gets back on it. Out to center ice, Jordan Eberle. He'll hit the line. He'll see his former team, the New York Islanders, tomorrow night. Yanni Gord moves it around to a vacated point, and it comes out to center. Under 90 seconds left on this power play. McCann sends it back. Seattle, 24th overall, 17th on the road. The Bruins are 9th overall and at home with their kill. Now Johansson through the middle. Hits the line, defers out to Gord. An attempt to get it back by 90. Johansson goes in. Riley plays it, not out. Held in by Giordano. Swept across, a wedge by Yarnkroak. Vakanainen with his back to the play. Gets help from no second. Here comes Curtis Lazar with Mike Riley shorthanded. Lazar to the outside. Out in front, Riley off the side of the goal. Activating from the D. And Seattle gets out of that one. 45 seconds left on their power play. Here's Wennberg. He'll take it in. Alex Wennberg to the top of your screen. Morgan Geeky, a giveaway. Marchand accelerates. Brad Marchand over the line, cuts, undone. No quarter given. He'll take it back off a stick, and that'll just kill more time. Brandon Carlo gets there ahead of Morgan Geeky. It pops out. Donato is there off a stick. It goes astray. Dunn moves in. He's shouldered by Carlo, and it comes back out. Hayden Fleury will settle it down. 13 seconds left in the manpower advantage. Fleury now through center. Off the stick of Wennberg, all the way back in Boston ice. Grizzlick is pressed by Donato. McAvoy's out of the box. Two kills for the Bruins. Out in front, cleaned up by Steen. A legal hand pass by McAvoy finds Fogarty. He'll clear it in. Stephen Fogarty, Cale Fleury for his brother Hayden. And Seattle's back out through center ice. Donskoy. Now Riley Shea and broken up Oscar Steen, who's earned a spot on this team. Young Swede, Fogarty through the middle. The outside, Anton Bleed. Bleed out of the corner. Fogarty gets the handle. Cale Fleury is all over him. They go to the corner. Riley Shea and pinned by Anton Bleed. Blackwell protects the puck. Grinds along the boards and sends it back for Cale. And now Jeremy Lauzon. Picked up by Riley Sheahan. He'll move it by McAvoy. Donskoy moves in. McAvoy out of the corner. Boston back out. Tomáš Nosek. Pasternak going wide. He looks to create a passing lane. Pasternak gets back on it. Winds it all the way around. Here's Mike Riley. Vakanainen takes it in. He'll go deep on his backhand. Lose control. Appleton back out to center ice. 6.5 left in this first period. Now Larson moved back and all the way around. Donato in control. Mason Appleton, great pass. Yanni Gord is just a skosh offside. And we get a stoppage. At some point, I'm going to get your thoughts about your dad. Trust me. 6:21 left in this first period. Non-stop action here in Boston. No score. Jen Mueller on the banks of the Charles River here in Boston. Center ice draw, Patrice Bergeron and Alex Wennberg. Kraken have had two unsuccessful power plays thus far. Brandon Carlo, Craig Smith, a dump in and back of Drieger to the corner. Lauzon goes to work on Bergeron. Wennberg in control. Vince Dunn, hogtied a bit, no call, they play on. Here's Jeremy Lauzon at the line. Donskoy off a defensive stick off Riley. The Bruins almost had a jailbreak, and now Marchand will take it back. Here's Brandon Carlo through the middle of the ice. Riley, a handoff, Bergeron off the blocker of Drieger. Marchand will get to it, in control, off a defensive stick. It went off Wennberg and back out to the center zone where it's shot in by Patrice Bergeron. Vince Dunn. We'll start from there. Shots are 7 for Seattle and 5 taken by Boston. Appleton. Lauzon. But Chris Drieger's had 3 gems already. To the wall. Yarnkroak double teamed. Charlie Coyle is one of those. Along with Charlie McAvoy. Hayden Fleury. Off Coyle. Oscar Steen. Aerial flip. Jake DeBrusque, who's been maligned by trade rumors all season, but he's still here. Now out of the corner. Hayden Fleury moved off the glass support. Coyle, a winder off Hayden Fleury out in front. Cale gets to it. And now Yanni Gord will take it back. Restart. Seattle changing. Boston changing. We're not changing. Now Gord through the middle. He'll send it in. Linus Ullmark, ex of Buffalo, lays it to the wall, cut off. Johansson for the Kraken. Loda Heilarsson snapping it this way for Giordano. His shot off a stick wide. Eberle was out in front. McCann to the point. Larsson this way. Giordano. Larsson again. In front. Tic-tac, no goal. Johansson and McCann almost combined. It comes out to center. Eberle takes it back. Hounded by Nosek. He survives it. Pasternak, a giveaway to McCann, and now Giordano. Mark Giordano through center. Shouldered by Nosek. Delayed offside against Seattle. They tag up. Back in Einem for Taylor Hall. David Pasternak threads it. Cut off. Vince Dunn. Quick up. Morgan Geeky for the front. Blackwell. Geeky pulls up off a skate. The Bruins swing out. Stephen Fogarty. Shifting at the line. No quarter given by Jeremy Lauzon. Anton Bleed inside the stripe. In front of that Seattle bench is muscled by Riley Sheahan. 3:37 left in his first period. Vince Dunn will kick it to his stick. Chip in charge off Blackwell. Ullmark in the trapezoid. Moves it around. Donato on a change. Anton Bleed has it. Good stick by Cale Fleury. And now McAvoy. And a handle for Chris Drieger. Hayden Fleury to the wall. He gives it away to McAvoy. Hayden Fleury stood up by Curtis Lazar. Four-man scrum. Bergeron, Donato both get there. Two former teammates. Marchand all over Donskoy. He'll send it back. Cale Fleury. Snappy pass for Wenberg and a reset. Now Cale from Hayden out to center. Wenberg to the outside. Here's Donskoy. He'll move it by Grizzlick. McAvoy. Safe area. Craig Smith. Through center. Cross ice pass. Marchand. And now he gets it back from Grizzlick. He'll lay it across for Bergeron. Off his stick. Smith moves in. Bergeron in front. Drieger says no. 2:35 left in the first period. Chris Drieger holding the fort here in Boston. We stay goalless.
Tonight, the Boston Bruins honor...
Brian Donato will be Jen Mueller's guest at the conclusion of the period. But again, growing up in a sports family, what's that like, JT?
Oh, it was great. You know, having a dad that played a professional sport, even though it wasn't hockey, it was nice to be able to have his insights of what it took to get to the highest level. So I know that happened in his family as well.
His dad's team, Harvard, we're told is down 2-0 early to Boston College. So he'll watch this game likely tomorrow, right? He's got other problems right now. Pair of 37s on the draw. Bergeron for Boston, destined for Hockey's Hall of Fame. Yanni Gourde is kicked out. Mason Appleton comes in. 2:35 left, period one. No score. Good start for Chris Drieger in goal. Out to center now. Mason Appleton crunched by Marchand. He's got it. Brad Marchand pulls up. Off a stick, off Yarncroke, and back out. Grizzlick. That's a reset from Charlie Coyle. Craig Smith outside the line. Crunched a bit by Mason Appleton. Giordano sends it back for Larsson. Here's Kelly Yarncroke. A shoot-in to the open corner. Icing is called here against Seattle. If you really want to flex your fandom, you need to get a Kraken license plate. Best part of these plates is a portion of the price comes back to support One Roof Foundation. These can be purchased from the Washington DOL or visit the site listed on the screen. Faceoff stays put in Kraken ice. Coyle for DeBrusk. Back in Einem, shifting. He'll take it in, a shot through traffic, a maze out in front. Dunn with the block. Vakanainen gets it back, centering pass off Coyle. He plays it off the back of the goal, does Vakanainen, and now to the outside, it's Gourde for Vince Dunn. Under duress, Yarncroke lends a helping hand. Wide open is Jeremy Lauzon. Appleton, ice cut in half by DeBrusk. Both go down, Gourde a give back. Seattle. 90 seconds left in this first period as they reorganize the shots, or even at seven. Vince Dunn off a stick. Marcus Johansson sends it in. Eberle gives chase, supported by McCann. Charlie McAvoy attempting to hunt it down for Boston. Sealing the wall is Marcus Johansson. A steal, it's Eberle. Out in front for McCann. A back check by Taylor Hall. Right on the spot. Nosek, McAvoy through center. It ricochets around to Jordan Eberle. Free, Johansson right in. It goes wide. McCann forks it deeper. And Taylor Hall has control. Through center. Pasternak. A lead pass for Hall. He throws snow at Larson. Nosek off the stick of Larson. Riley fumbles it at the point. The Bruins tag up. A shoot in by Brandon Carlo. Adam Larson. Hayden Fleury now. 29 seconds left in the first. The first of two meetings. Boston's in Seattle on February 24th. Wenberg takes it back. Hayden Fleury sends it across for Larson. Slow developing breakout for Seattle. Boston postured through the middle. It comes in on Ullmark. He'll deal it off the glass. Back out to the neutral zone. Hayden Fleury takes it back. 3 seconds left here in period one as the siren goes at TD Garden. Kraken intermission presented by Jack in the Box will come your way next. Ryan Donato will visit with Jen Mueller. 8 shots for Seattle, 7 shots taken by Boston. Best player in the period for my money, Chris Drieger. After 20 minutes of play in Beantown, the Kraken, the Bruins, goalless.
Kraken have held it down after one period in a TD Garden against the Boston Bruins. 0-0 in the third of a four-game road trip for Seattle in their inaugural NHL season. Welcome into the Root Sports Studio. Ross Fletcher, Nick Gismondi with you. Let's talk about Chris Drieger. As John Forsland said there, stellar in that first period. You talk pre-game about his frenetic style, and we saw it in great effect there.
That's just his style, and that's where he gets the energy going, especially with some early on saves, and the guys feed off of that. Very different styles and goal between he and Grubauer, both very effective, but look at that side to side. Big first save right there. Has to be sharp on it. Knows this shot is coming through traffic, manages to get down low. Beautiful spread across on this one, and then he just fillets himself out to make saves like that. When you can make big saves like that, it energizes your team. So you're like, okay, Driggs is ready to go. Let's make sure we're jumping with him.
Strong defensive performance. Let's talk about the power play. 2 for 27 in their last 8 games. Why is it not clicking?
Just trying too hard here, trying to make that extra pass, not getting shots through, and then when they do make that pass, it's missing. So it's about simplicity. Make a 3-foot pass, get it to your guy, get a puck on net, and just try for anything right now. Also, Ross, if you're asking me, more traffic in front of the net.
Okay, let's see if the Kraken can get that moving and get some goals on the board, because for every goal scored by the Kraken this season, WSECU will donate $250 to the Boys and Girls Clubs of Washington State. Well, they were out there together for a few minutes. It's those guys who are a little bit older now, Hayden and Cale Fleury. For the Kraken, we will hear from their parents next.
Jim is presented to you by Jack in the Box.
I don't know if you saw that viral clip of the Columbus kid doing the Spinnerama goal the other day. This was not quite there, but pretty good. The Selly is better, though. Except his teammate, I'm not quite sure he meant that. Well done, young man. Ross Fletcher, Nick Gismondi with you. A couple of brothers out there for the Kraken tonight. Only the second time this season that Hayden and Cale Fleury as brothers are playing together in the NHL. A Chicago pair were the only other this season. So proud parents, John and Sandy Fleury. They're back home watching right now. We've been asking them about the excitement of it all.
Crazy exciting today. Much more emotional today than it was when they teamed up in the exhibition. Sandy was able to go to the game in Calgary. I wasn't able to attend because of work, but it didn't really seem to be as special. Today is really special. I wish we could be there in Boston to see it live, but it's going to be pretty exciting to watch it on television.
They worked really hard to get where they are today, so we always told them it wasn't a sprint, it's a marathon. So they keep on working hard and they'll get their dreams. So it's pretty special.
John, how were the boys as buddies growing up, as brothers? I think a little more than a two-year age difference. That's about the same as I have with my brother. We had some good brotherly battles, you know, as kids. What were Cale and Hayden like growing up when they weren't at the rink?
Wow, competitive. Backyard rinks from the time they were 3-5 years old. Very competitive there. Both boys went on to Notre Dame after they were done their minor hockey, and they played in Wilcox, Saskatchewan at Notre Dame. Both had their 2 years there, 1 year midget, 1 year bantam. So they had some common stuff there. But I think where the real competitive comes out, other than when they played each other in the Western League, when Kootenay played against Red Deer, things got a little bit heated a couple times there on the ice. But the golf course, we're family, we've golfed together. The four of us have golfed together since the boys have been old enough to walk. So we have some really good battles. Sandy and I take on the boys every year, and we give them all they can handle.
Very good. Finally, Sandy, when you found out the boys were going to be part of this Seattle Kraken organization, this expansion team, did you have any thoughts about that opportunity for both of them?
Yeah, because we were kind of shocked when they called us. Cale had called Hayden and said, like, I'm going to the Kraken too. And then they merged Don and I, and then I think I didn't even have anything to say. I was probably in shock that they were both going to be on the same team, and maybe a few tears too to go along with it. But that's pretty special.
Great day for the Flurry family. More still to come, of course. Zeros for the Kraken and the Bruins. We'll hear from Ryan Donato next.
Presented by Jack in the Box, the Kraken are 5-1-1 against Atlantic Division teams. One of the best records in the league, trying to improve on that impressive stat tonight. Hey everybody, Angie Mentink with you at the Ford Sports Desk. You could understand if Ryan Donato was veering towards the wrong dressing room today. He grew up the son of former Bruin Ted Donato. Then Ryan was selected by the Bruins in the second round of the 2014 NHL Draft. To help collect his sense of direction, Arjen Mueller stopped him and caught up with him as he came off the ice and headed to the Kraken dressing room.
When you watched the first few minutes of that game, it looked like Drager came out on fire. What kind of jolt and energy did that bring early on?
You know, it's great having a goalie that has confidence in the back end, and we have two of them right now. And I think we're doing everything we can to keep the puck out of the net, but he's doing the extra step for us right now, and we're thankful to have him.
We've seen a lot of rushes both ways in this one. How do you capitalize in the second?
Just get more pucks to the net. I think we're doing a little bit to try to do much to make a pretty play. I think if we get some more rubber on the net, it might be a greasy goal, and hopefully it goes in.
Lastly, we've talked about your connection here to Boston a lot before the game. What's the piece of hockey advice from your dad that you always take out there?
I mean, it's these memories that you remember after you're done playing. Friends and family, the connections you make, and the friends on your team, and every opportunity you get to play in front of your home fans, it's special.
Well, go enjoy the rest of this one.
Thank you very much.
Awesome perspective in the middle of it. Here's a look at your first period McDelivery Supermo moments. Chris Drieger just got engaged while there in Boston. Make an amazing save. Ladies, I hate to tell you, Drieger off the market. I will take the opportunity to remind you, though, that our Nick Gismondi is still available, ladies.
As we get set for the second period, and we'll take a look at the numbers after the first period of play. Seattle had two power plays empty-handed. Boston had seven shots, but had quality chances on Chris Drieger, who gets the start here tonight, and he was outstanding in the first period, and he is the subject of tonight's WaFed Bank save of the game.
Chris Drieger's a big part of this 0-0 scoreline, and it's because of saves like this. A good passing play out in front, Craig Smith gets a chance, then Brad Marchand gets a chance as well. Drieger staying in position, able to get the glove on it. Down and out, you would think, but not right there. He gets one little piece, sends the puck up and over the net. Some good play from Chris Drieger.
Snoqualmie Casino Sportsbook, opening faceoff of the second period, will include Alex Wenberg for Seattle as we peer down inside the walls of TD Garden. Tomasz Nosek for the Bruins. The road trip will end tomorrow. The All-Star break will ensue after that. We will hit the air from the brand new barn in Belmont, New York.
The Kraken, the Islanders. We start with Kraken pregame, presented by Coors Light at 3:30 Pacific time. John Forslund, JT Brown, Jen Mueller, supported by our fantastic crew. Taylor Hall, broken up by Boston's Ryan Donato, who now plays for Seattle. It goes off the glove of Brandon Carlo out to center. Comes all the way back. Mike Riley in control. Paired on defense with Brandon Carlo. Here's Hall. Pulled down by Dunn. Wenberg ties up his man. It's let go. They play on. That man was Nosek. A drop pass is broken up here in the second period of the long change. Lauzon will take it back. He'll address it from there. A quick up. A chip by Ryan Donato for a line change. Lena Zollmark. Mike Riley on the wall. Jake DeBrusque through the middle. Oscar Steen. Not deep enough. Cut off by Cale Fleury. Hayden Fleury in control. Off the stick of Appleton. Right here for Yanni Gord. Yarncroft denied by Ullmark. Hayden Fleury punches one deep. Mike Riley awaiting for Boston. Hounded by Gord. Yanni gets to it. He'll clear it to the far side. Hayden Fleury plays it deep. Yanni Gord in back of the goal. Out in front by Appleton. It kicks around and Jake DeBrusque will get to it. Boston back out to center. Charlie Coyle, who's a New Englander. He'll get it deep. DeBrusque out in front off the paddle of Drieger. Play to the boards and out. Yanni Gord marches out to the red line. Moves it by Derek Forbert. Comes back in. Back a nine. And heavy hit. He's laid out by Yanni Gord. And he's down. There'll be a disturbance right here, JT, because of all of that. A punishing hit by Yanni Gord.
Yeah, it was a big hit behind the net. Yanni just doing what he does best, getting in hard on the forecheck. Initial glance, it looked clean. You can see Yanni going in. Playing a big hit right there. Yeah, it looks like he hits him in the back of the shoulder there. Yeah. Doesn't look like there was actual shoulder-to-head contact. That's what Yanni was saying. They're going to talk about it, but you know, sometimes you do end up rubbing your face up against the glass, and I think that's where the injury occurs.
Yeah, the compression causes the cut. The referees tonight, Gislain Hébert, Eric Furlot. Crowd sees it on the big Jumbotron. Of course, they are partisan. They'll moan about it, but I'm with you. He made an effort, Yanni did, I believe, to get the shoulder, not between the numbers. But this is a long discussion, and the linesman, JT, as you know, can also have their say here.
Yeah, I think you have to look and see where the first contact is made, and I don't think there was any head contact made with Yanni's shoulder or arm going through on the hit.
So we wait it out, as do the Kraken, as do the Bruins. 18:22 left in this second period. We'll see it one more time. And there's going to be a call.
A major penalty call in play. We're going to look at it.
Wow. So they're going to call major and they're going to take a look at it and they can take it down from there. But they go to the top. They have levied a major penalty on Yanni Gord.
I would think they'd have to bring that down. I don't see a major there.
So they'll take a look at their own work here. This is a really nice adjustment by the National Hockey League a couple of years ago to let the referees do this. This game has played at an unbelievable rate of speed. It's a hard job for these guys.
Yeah, it's definitely hard. You see, you know, a big hit like that and there's an injury on the play. So you want to be able to protect players, but you can go in and get a second look and make sure you get the right call.
So they continue to deliberate. The All-Star break, as we pointed out, will start after tomorrow's game against the Islanders. The Kraken will start after the break February 9th against Arizona at Climate Pledge Arena.
Yeah, for me, I'm looking to see if Yanni makes contact with the head at any point, you know, through that shoulder or arm going through, and I don't see it there.
No, I'm with you. I don't either.
If he does, then yes, I can see where the major comes into play, but from those views and from that vantage point, it looks like Yanni did everything he could not to make sure there was head contact on the play.
And for me, if it's that malicious, they should know right away. I mean, this thing here is taking forever. So if you're looking at it and all these different ways to look at things, major penalty is pretty malicious, right?
It should be obvious,
it should be
right?
Stark. We'll get the interpretation.
After further review, a minor penalty for boarding has been awarded.
So it's a minor penalty. And that's good because Yanni can stay in the game. It'll give Boston their first power play.
Yeah, you definitely didn't want to see this power play at home getting a 5 minute, you know, 5 minutes to work with.
So Bruce Cassidy will send out the number 6 power play in the NHL, the number 2 power play at home at almost 29%. Kraken kill tied for 21st overall, tied for 26th on the road. Boston's power play is 4 out of 13 in the last 5, and the Kraken have killed off 11 of 16 in the same time period. Bergeron in the circle, opposed by Riley Sheahan. Sheahan, Donskoy, Larson, and Giordano, quartet of killers. McAvoy awaits at the point. He'll walk the line, draw it away from Riley Sheahan. Marchand in control. Brad Marchand to the goal line. Hall in front off Drieger. Second chance forked astray by Patrice Bergeron. This is Charlie McAvoy. David Pasternak, a wrister wide with Hall out in front. Taylor Hall, David Pasternak, who's deadly in his office right here. Shot taken, rubbed out. Good block. Adam Larson out of the corner. Pasternak tries to feed across. A good read by Jonas Donskoy. Partial 2-on-1 with Giordano. His shot is snared by Omar. And the Bruins break it out. Marchand through the middle. Hits the line. He's in the zone. He goes wide. He'll pull up. Bergeron bumps it out. McAvoy pawed down by Drieger. He got the rebound off Hall. Now Pasternak out of the corner. Back again for Charlie McAvoy. In the ring, Marchand. Bergeron, good stick. Kelly Arncroft prevents the chance. Blackwell off the boards. Gets it deep. Comes all the way back down. Now McAvoy. Brad Marchand. Dogged by Wennberg. Charlie Coyle. Interrupted again by Wennberg, a puck battle. Jeremy Lauzon sends it down to Linus Ullmark. And now Matt Grizzlick with 35 seconds left on the manpower advantage. Second unit out for Boston. A stutter step or two by Grizzlick. Coyle, Pasternak cradles the puck. Shoots one, swallowed up by Drieger twice. The third time he's got it. Jake DeBrusk hovering over him.
Pretty action-packed power play so far. Donskoy is going to get a 2-on-1, short-handed. Good opportunity, looks up, makes the right decision, whether to pass or shoot. Ullmark does a good job of playing that puck so they can keep going back on the attack. Boston getting pucks to the net, getting second-chance opportunities in front with Drieger looking strong, having to be the best killer.
In tight. Maintaining his positioning. Good work by Drieger. Now Giordano by Grizzlick. Gord has 15 seconds left to serve. Mike Riley. It was a trading deadline acquisition a season ago from Ottawa. Coyle, Riley walks in, out in front, off Coyle, captured by Yarncroak to the boards. Giordano, Gord's out. Now Grizzlick, pestered by Yanni Gord. Charlie Coyle in control. Brian Donato is all over him. Craig Smith out of the University of Wisconsin. Riley right on, scooped up by Drieger. No further play. Bruins had 3 shots on that power play. And Drieger, JT, really in control.
He has to be the best penalty killer when you're in a situation like that. It's an important kill. You know, for a player that brings a lot of energy and a lot to the game, you want to definitely kill it off for him.
Seattle Kraken Super Skills Showcase, Saturday, February 12th, 3 p.m. Climate Pledge Arena. I'm not sure they'll have some of this stuff,
in the skills competition, but this is entertaining, and Yanni Gourde's in the middle of it. The Bruins want to police that hit. It's Curtis Lazar, and now on the near boards, Jeremy Lauzon and Derek Forbert. They don't have a history. This is Forbert's first season as a Bruin. With 4 minutes gone here in the second period.
We had to wonder if something like this was going to happen. Boston obviously didn't like the hit by Yanni Gourde. You're going to look at it right off the draw right there. Gets a cross-check. Lazar goes right in after Yanni Gourde. You'd have to think that there's going to be an extra penalty involved on this play. They're going right after Yanni, right at the face-off. Doesn't give him an option. Yes, policing yourself, but you also, you know, I'm all for fighting in hockey, but you got to give both sides a chance to step in.
Yeah. No doubt about that. So again, to clean up the skills competition, Climate Pledge Arena, 3 p.m. Tickets are $10 across the board. All of the proceeds will benefit One Roof Foundation. Be a great day. No room at the inn. Bruins have three players in the box. Seattle has two. Bruce Cassidy wants an explanation, as does Dave Hextall. No penalties on the board in terms of a power play as of yet. We do have outnumbered situations with just bodies, but penalties could still wash out. Eric Furlott in conversation with Bruce Cassidy. Okay. The Kraken appear to send out five players. There's an extra two on the board for Curtis Lazar. So that means Seattle has their third power play. They have three shots in their previous two. Muckleshoot Casino power play. Johansson, Yarncroke, Eberle, McCann, and Giordano. And straight away, it's dumped out by Boston's Charlie McAvoy. Jared McCann. One goal shy of his career best. He's taken down by Marchand. It comes out to center. Yarncroke. Jordan Eberle gains entry. He tried to forge it by Carlo. He gets it back. Giordano walks the line. In the ring, McCann, a shot off the mark. Eberle goes by him. Marchand has some open ice. So pull up on Giordano. Cut across. Protect the puck. Kill some more time. Bergeron. Here's Marchand. Broken up. Johansson on the way back for Seattle. The Kraken out to center. Marcus Johansson at the line. Off the skate of Carlo. Held in by Eberle. To the corner, Johansson. He'll saucer the puck for Jordan Eberle. In back of the goal now, Marcus Johansson kicks it to his stick. Eberle dances a bit along the wall. Draws it away from DeBrusk. Here's McCann. Eberle now pops out, advances through the slot. Nobody home. Vince Dunn on the backside. Muscled by Grizzlick. Yarncroke. McCann. Eberle holding onto it. Jared McCann straight away. And the second opportunity, a wrist shot through a screen wide. Vince Dunn anticipates away from Charlie Coyle, but he's forced out to center. Good work by Coyle. McCann will kick it to his stick. Eberle in control. Shortening up on the twig is DeBrusk. Here he comes. He'll move it in.
Boston penalty to number 20, Curtis Lazar, 2 minutes for roughing. Boston penalty to number 28, Derek Forbert, 5 minute major for fighting.
So Lazar got the extra minor for roughing out of that, with majors for Forbert and Lauzon for fighting. Gourde gets a roughing minor, as does Fogarty. Shot taken, Omark the save, he got the rebound, Donskoy on the follow-up. That'll just about do it in terms of the power play as the Kraken knock on the door. Wenberg will come back. Lazar's out of the box. 13:53 left in the second period, goalless here at the Garden. Goes by Omark to the wall. Donato jumps on it. Rims it around for Larson. He'll scale it back. Picked off by Mike Riley. Gained by Larson off a defensive stick off McAvoy. Hayden Fleury. Morgan Geeky. Hayden in control. His shot easily detected by Linus Omark. 13:33 left to go in the second period. The Kraken, no shots on the last power play. We still look for our first goal here in Boston. We come back with the Brothers Fleury and the Pemco defender of your Northwest tonight. We'll go all the way back. These two have never played professionally, but they did at this point, JT, in the very early stages of their careers, as you see them side by side. Cale grew a great deal to catch up to Hayden. There's no doubt about it. The only way you know is by the way they shoot, right? So, but a terrific moment for the two of them. There's no question about it. And it extends back. You were there the day of the expansion draft when Hayden found out that his brother Cale was selected. And he said, man, if we get a chance, what a dream come true. Cale's had a good season in Charlotte. His best year, 19-20 in Montreal. Gord right out in front, just by Yarnbrook. As it rolled off his stick, Cale Fleury at the point. Moved along, Yarnbrook in control. Here's Gord, he'll convert it. Take it in on Riley. Play it up top for Hayden. He'll clear it all the way around. Goes by Gord. Cale with a pinch. Moving in on DeBrusque. It pops out. Yarnbrook slams it off a body. Brandon Carlo, now Steen, doesn't see it. It goes to the corner. Appleton for Seattle. Hayden Fleury at the point. Wristing one off sticks. Gord in the slot as it kicks around and finally dumped off the boards and out by Oscar Steen. Larson a quick up. Appleton, 12:40 left in the second. Here comes Marchand. He lost the handle. Played by Larson. Appleton swings it out. Ryan Donato. Alex Wenberg, 10-2 with the skates, moves it, then he's sealed off by Smith. McAvoy, Marchand under pressure, Grizzlick takes over. Moved along for Patrice Bergeron. He'll clear it off the end glass. Drieger almost gave it away. Giordano, a good job to shift around Marchand, and now Adam Larson accelerates through center. Drops it off for Donskoy. Jonas Donskoy shifting on Smith, throws on the brakes, cycles high. Here's Giordano, one-timer Larson, a slap pass off McAvoy, and it's captured by Craig Smith. Marchand looks around, hits the line, plays it off Donskoy, who's backtracking. He's got it. He's flushed out by Craig Smith. Come out to center ice. Moving the zone. He's a lone ranger here. Sealed off by Carlo. Seattle is changing. Nosek in control. Tomasz Nosek. Right by Johansson. Then he goes by McCann. Takes it to dead center. Sets up Mike Riley, who moves it across for Taylor Hall. Hall shifting on McCann. Goes to the corner as the crowd is heard from. It comes all the way across for Riley. His shot blocker down. Good save by Drieger. To the boards now. Eberle will fish it back out. Brandon Carlo cuts it off at the pass. He's tripped up by Johansson. And a penalty is called.
Johansson going in along this near side wall. He has a little bit of a battle here, trying to pick up the puck. Oh, it kind of looked like he might have just fallen on his own there. Drieger, good save, fighting through. A little bit of a screen there. Johansson just trying to pick up the stick. You see Carlo go down there.
Second power play for the Bruins. Three shots on the first one. Bergeron, Hall, Marchand, Pastrnak, and McAvoy. That's the power play. Giordano. With Larson on the back end. Sheahan, Donskoy up front. Charlie McAvoy defers to the outside for Marchand. He'll take it into the goal line. Hall. Here's Pastrnak. He scores! David Pastrnak with a blast in his office. And Pastrnak has given the Bruins a 1-0 lead on the power play.
You always have to know where Pastrnak is on this power play. When the puck goes low, usually the play is to go to the back post. They have Bergeron on that backside. It takes the defenders away. You look at Larson, he's got to defend that post. It opens up the seam to Pastrnak. And he goes on and off the stick for a one-timer a smart play by Boston. They have two options off that low play, and that one right there is a lethal shooter.
The Bruins now have 11 power play goals in their last 10 games, clicking at almost 40%. David Pastrnak scored 12 goals in the month of January, and he adds to it. For Pastrnak, his 21st goal of the season, as Driedger melts it down.
Get another look at this penalty going in. Carlo with the puck. Looks like he's going in, trying to do a tight turn. Johansson just has his stick. He looks like he falls on his own there, so unfortunate break for Seattle. It's called for a penalty, and Boston scores on the play.
Boyle now moves it back. Grzelcyk lines it all the way around. Dunn saddled up by Lazar. Out of that scrum, DeBrusk. Curtis Lazar gets it back. Moves away from Geeky. Trading places with DeBrusk, hammered by McAvoy, wide of a drifting Driedger. Now, Poyle, muscled by Geeky. It goes by Jake DeBrusk. Good play by Lozon to set up Dunn, who takes a hit. But he can't get it out. Charlie Coyle moves it across, back door, McAvoy. Picked up by Lozon. Now Riley Sheahan moves it. On its edge, where Blackwell will settle it down for Dunn. Halfway through, Boston, David Pastrnak has the goal. They have the lead, and now Omark on a tee for McAvoy. Shots are 14 Boston, 13 Seattle. Kraken will take on the New York Islanders. On Long Island tomorrow, it's cleared in by Charlie McAvoy all the way around. Cale Fleury for Hayden. Hayden Fleury out of the corner. Cale now takes a peek up ice. Indirect pass for Donskoy, broken up as it was read by Marchand. Taken back by the Bruins defense, broken up now. Donskoy out in front, good read by Mike Riley to pick it off to the point. Cale Fleury, Hayden goes wide, he'll shoot one, caught by Linus Ullmark. 9 minutes, 15 seconds left in the second period. 21st goal of the season, where he does all of his business. David Pastrnak on the power play, 1-0. Well, the city has a great history. The country was born here, and of course, the original six history of the Bruins, the retired numbers, the great number four, Bobby Orr. Time now for a taste of our Taco Bell take. We talked about this Troika in the open. They usually play on the same line. You take a look at those incredible numbers, and for David Pastrnak, who has scored here tonight, he's just getting started. Marchand and Bergeron likely to be in the Hall of Fame someday, and Pastrnak will trend in the same vein. Dunn blocked by Craig Smith. They'll play it all the way back in. McCann out in front, read by McAvoy. Smith on the wall, pops it out. Johansson, Jeremy Lozon, the former Bruin, goes across. Through center, it's McCann to shoot in. A failure to contain by Omark. It goes to the corner. Eberle off a body, captured by McCann. Low to high, Dunn. Here's Lozon, a broken stick. Call the factory on that one, out of the corner now. Eberle is tied up. Grzelcyk, as it comes across for Craig Smith. Pounded a bit by Dunn. Good gap there. Eberle takes a hit from Grzelcyk. Johansson clipped. He's down. Injured. Adam Larson draws it back. Play comes to a halt. We'll check out the status of Marcus Johansson.
Well, the ref pointed directly right away, saying it was your own player's stick. It was Eberle's stick that caught him up high. We get the look here, and it is Everly's own stick, goes into Johansson. Unfortunate. Ref is right there, though, automatically seen. He's seen it right away. Let Everly know when he was complaining that it was your own stick that hit him. So it's a good call, or a good no call, I guess, in that situation.
And because of that, the faceoff will come back in the Seattle zone. Fogarty opposed by Yanni Gord. Larson moves it, a read by Riley. Knocks it down along the boards. Kicked back by Yarncroke. Here's Giordano off a stick. He was hassled by Anton Bleed. It comes out. Appleton gets involved with Carlo, and a penalty against Boston. Driedger for the bench.
They blow it dead. 8:03 left. Interference is the call.
Boston 25, Montreal interference.
This one's a pretty easy call to make. The puck's up in the air. Carlo doesn't get all of it. Sees the puck go behind him. Appleton's trying to jump around. Just takes away that time and space. Sticks his stick out. Doesn't allow Appleton to skate through. That's an easy one. Again, you have a power play. It's been back and forth. It hasn't looked great at times for Seattle on the power play, but you have another opportunity. You know what their looks are. You know how they're pressuring. Hopefully this time you're able to break through.
Now's the time. Yanni Gord, Kelly Yarncroak, Jordan Eberle. Giordano, McCann are back. Eberle takes it in on Lazar, and he's picked up by McAvoy. Giordano, this way McCann. Eberle wide open, a shot kicked out by Omar. McAvoy can't get it out. Good play by Eberle. Giordano, bumper slot by Yarncroak, negated. Forbert out in front, dumped out of the zone by Charlie McAvoy. A buck 35 left on Seattle's fourth Muckleshoot Casino power play. Giordano sends it back for Eberle through the middle of the ice. It's a clean entry. It goes to the corner, furthered by McCann. Yarncroak, Giordano, he'll tangle to the outside of Coyle. Eberle traps the zone. High slot, Yarncroak, Gord. Yarncroak, one-timer, blocked in front. The Bruins get it out, thanks to Tomasz Nosek. Halfway through the power play for Seattle. Just about 13 minutes gone in the second period. John, JT, and Jen tonight from TD Garden. Jonas Donskoy through center. Hits the line at the outside. It's Kiki. He'll corral it. Lay it back for Dunn. This way, Donato wide. It careens back for Dunn. They trap the zone. Jonas Donskoy awaits. Moved along to the boards for Ryan Donato. Broken up by Jake DeBrusque. Right out of play. Delay of game. 38 seconds of 5-on-3 time for Seattle.
Boston 74, Montreal Canadiens, the real game.
The dreaded puck over the glass. You know what DeBrusque is trying to do. You get this puck on your backhand, quickly get it all the way down the ice. Doesn't touch the glass, puts you on a 5-on-3. Here's a good cross-seam pass over to Eberle for an opportunity on that power play. Now you're going to have a little bit more time and space for 38 seconds with this 5-on-3.
The Kraken have 2 5-on-3 goals this season. Giordano holding on to it. To the line, Eberle. Giordano awaiting. A shot taken wide. And you have to hit the target because this is what happens. It comes all the way back. It kills time. 22 seconds left. 5-on-3. Boston has allowed 2 goals on a two-man disadvantage this season. Kraken offside on entry. 16 seconds left in terms of the 5-on-3, 1:39, the overall power play.
Yeah, right now they're just not helping themselves. Like you said, if you miss the net, it goes all the way down. If you go offsides on a 5-on-3, it stops the play. Now you have to reset. Now it's all on this faceoff if they can win it, and there's still not a lot of time left.
No. Gord and Bergeron. Face-off win, Bergeron possession though, Seattle. Moved in, McCann, Jordan Eberle holding onto it. Back it goes, Giordano, his shot stopped by Ullmark, it kicks around, Giordano, McCann will cradle in the ring. Broken stick. Forbert dumps it out. Conventional 5-on-4. For a minute and 12 seconds now. Under 6 left in the second, 1-0 Boston. Power play strike from David Pastrnak. Here comes Donskoy. They play it off the boards. Morgan Geeky settles back for Dunn. Vince Dunn sends it in. Off the end boards. Donato in a puck battle. Forbert is on him. Wenberg attempting to get to it. Out of the scrum, Donato chips it back for Dunn. He'll walk the line. One-timer sizzles wide. Morgan Geeky. Same story. It comes all the way back down. 39 seconds left on the power play. Now it's cranked up by Vince Dunn. Geeky with a give back. This is Donskoy still looking for that first goal. Wenberg broken up a bit. Geeky sets it up for Dunn. Now Morgan Geeky starts again. Takes it deeper. Looks around. Lays it back for Dunn. Donato's on this side awaiting. Skate to stick, Geeky. He'll take it in. Indirectly back for Dunn. Here's Donato, a one-timer block. Canceled in front by Matt Grizzlick. And the Bruins get it out. So, 3 seconds left. Jake DeBrusk, his sentence is now over. Here comes Appleton. Appleton will circle the track. Peel away for McAvoy, even terms on the ice. Blackwell for Cale Fleury. And now Colin Blackwell. Shot taken over the head of Ullmark. And all the way out, Hayden Fleury. Paired with his brother on defense. Here's Blackwell. Appleton fumbles it. Pasternak has it. Gloved down by Cale Fleury. Good play. Blackwell over skates. Pasternak to an open flank. Nosek moves in. Ridden off it by Cale Fleury. Taylor Hall in front. Pasternak, a give back. McAvoy. David Pasternak. The give and go. Broken up by Blackwell. Pasternak goes deep again. Here's Nosek. 3:55 left in the second period. Off the shin guard of Hall. Shan. They score! Taylor Hall never gave up. Fumbled in front. Riley Shan had a tough time. 3:51 left in the second period. 2-0 Boston.
Had a tough time with the puck. Puck ends up getting right out in front. Hall doesn't give up on the play. Off the stick, right to Hall. Hall's able to put that one in quickly on Driedger. Puck's just moving. A good forecheck from Boston. You get into that area, Hall fights back for that puck and is able to put it home on that low side.
So Dave Hextall knows that two goals is a lot against this team. We'll see where it goes from here. 3:42 left in the second period. Donato, power move, shut down by Ullmark. Anton Bleed. Out to center, greeted there by Adam Larson. Donskoy gave it away to Bleed. Anton Bleed with a shot, fended off by Driedger. Out of the corner, Oscar Steen lays it back. Fogarty to the point. Carlo off the bevy of humanity out in front. Forked in on Driedger. Where is it? Chris Driedger says, I've got it. Little disturbance out in front. The boys will separate. 3 minutes, 15 seconds left in the second period, and a beautiful look at the old State House here in Boston, Massachusetts, where Taylor Hall has given the home team a 2-0 lead. Back inside the Garden here in Boston, John Forsland, JT Brown, Jen Mueller. Off the draw, Brandon Carlo to the outside, sealed off a bit. A shoulder jolt by Larson, DeBrusk, low to high, Riley. His shot, blocker down with a purpose by Driedger. Mason Appleton now takes it back in his own zone.
Boston,
scrum in the corner as they tie it up. It's a unassisted goal for Taylor Hall, his 10th goal of the campaign. Has made it 2-0 Boston.
Time of the goal, 16.
They continue to jam. They being Lazar, Larson, a host of others. They continue to grind it here. DeBrusk moves it. Lozon caught in the way for Seattle. He has it, and now Adam Larson springs it out to Gord, who drops it off for Appleton, who moves it deep in the zone. Brandon Carlo gets to it. Forechecked by Kelly Yarncroak. Gord sealed off by Charlie Coyle. Carlo now out of the corner. Appleton tries to pry it out. They jam. Played along the boards and back. Giordano off the traffic. Picked up by Mike Riley. Aerial flip. DeBrusk tries to move in. Negated by Dunn. Gord moves it across. Here comes Vince Dunn. Everly for the front. His shot blockered away by Ullmark and directed out of play.
Good play moving through the neutral zone. Yanni Gord gets a nice little one-touch over to Dunn. Dunn jumping up in the play. That's something Seattle's going to need their defenseman to do. Jump up when the time is right.
Right.
He's able to use the defenseman as a screen. Blockered it up and out of play. But those are the good things that Seattle can do to get back in the game.
Takes off win. Giordano on a set play. Blocked in front. Everly now. McCann. Bergeron. Shoulder on shoulder with Blackwell. And now Forbert to the far side. McAvoy one arms it in. Derek Forbert. It eludes Marchand. Dunn cushions the puck. Plays it to the corner. Eberle goes down but keeps it deep in the zone. Colin Blackwell hounding it for Seattle. Giving a shove there as they jam in the corner. It again comes out and rolls to Marchand. Out to center, Patrice Bergeron. Marchand has a lane. His shot is snared by Treger. No further play.
Well, this line attacks so quickly through the neutral zone. The puck gets over to Marchand. A good shot over on that blocker side. Glove side. Drieger's able to paw that one down. Put it in. No rebound, but they attack quickly through the neutral zone, kick it out one way, and they want to shoot right away.
And they want the next one. No doubt about it. Kraken trying to prevent it. Late goal here for them would do wonders. Now Grizzlick to the outside. Pasternak stopped again by Drieger. In back of the goal, Taylor Hall. He'll take it out. Stop and start. Cale Fleury is on him. Hayden Fleury plays it to the boards. Ryan Donato sends it back. Hayden now. Quick up. Donato. Shadowed by Nosek. Jonas Donskoy moves it. Not deep enough. Carlo back out. Just about 40 seconds left in the second period. Taylor Hall has one tonight. David Pasternak has the other, and he crosses offside. Make the most of the season by joining the Depths, the official Kraken membership program. Get first access to ticket releases, invitations to private team events and practices, exclusive content, annual gifts, and much more. Go to KrakenMembership.com to sign up. Adam Larson. D to D passing with Jeremy Lauzon. It comes back in. A handle ahead of the goal line by Ullmark. Played all the way around now. Yarnkroak at the point. Geeky to the outside. Lauzon. His shot seen all the way by Ullmark. No problem there. 18 seconds left in the second period.
All shots are good shots if you're Seattle right now, but like you said, he saw it all the way. You got to find a way to fight through the checks, get to the front of the net, and try to take away his eyes.
Be a change here, the last change likely for both sides. McCann, Eberle, Donato for Seattle. With Giordano and Dunn back. Coyle wins it on his power side for Charlie McAvoy. Curtis Lazar, 11 seconds left in the second. Shots are even at 18, score is not. Boston by two. Here comes McAvoy. He'll shift in, center one off a body. It'll come out to center. And we hear the siren again at TD Garden. Stay connected for Kraken Intermission, presented by Verizon. A rocket, a power play dart by David Pasternak. Start of the scoring, then an unassisted goal by Taylor Hall on a turnover. It's been rough. We've had some pleasantries, but it's Boston with two strikes in the second period after 40 minutes in Beantown. The Bruins 2, the Kraken, no score.
Joe. It's no tea party in Boston. Feisty and physical in that second period, and the Boston Bruins leading the Kraken by 2-0. Ross Fletcher, Nick Gismondi with you in the Root Sports studios. Let's get right into that physical play. 4 minutes in, Yanigor called for the penalty, but the referees took a long time to determine the punishment here, but was it even a penalty?
Hits are 17-12 right now. It's a physical game. I don't think so. I mean, I've watched this a couple of times. I've watched it with you. I mean, listen, the only thing you could say is that the Boston player is in a smidge of a vulnerable position, but Gore doesn't hit him up too high. I don't think it was a boarding.
Does intent matter here?
It does, for sure, part of it. You got to be looking at that. I don't really think it was there, though.
Then the fight, of course, the revenge Boston on Gore. And we ended up with five guys in the box.
No major penalty on that. I really don't understand why Boston took the exception to try to start that fight, and then even why in that situation Gord went to the box for fighting. He got jumped, kept his gloves on. A confusing period for me in terms of what the referees were looking at.
Yeah, we didn't even see much reaction from the Boston players initially to that Gord hit.
Nothing, yeah, and that's another telling factor.
Yeah, we'll break down more of the physical play in a moment. Marcus Johansson's penalty for tripping, which again could be debated, which led to the opening Boston goal. We'll have a look at that in just a mo.
Brick of the NHL.
Uphill task for the Kraken to get back in this one from TD Garden. The Bruins leading 2-0 right now. David Pastrnak and Taylor Hall with the unassisted second goal. Ross Fletcher, Nick Gismondi with you. A little bit of controversy maybe about the opening goal for the Bruins. 9 penalties in the game. Marcus Johansson here was called for one for tripping. Was it?
Again, I'm a little perplexed at what the stripes you see it in this one here. I'm not a referee, so far be it for me to be overly critical. But from that angle, sure. I was sitting watching the game with you, and I'm like, yeah, he tripped him. And then I watched this angle right here, and I don't believe that's the case at all. I think he just lost his footing there and went down.
Well, that led to the power play for Boston. They scored off it with our Emerald Queen Casino Tracer. Break down the Pastrnak goal for us.
Well, first of all, I like everything that's going on here on the penalty kill initially. It's good, it's clean, it's concise. But then when that puck comes down low, it's just a little bit too much of a look by 72 White. That's Donskoy. And all of this space for a guy that knows how to shoot the puck, Pastrnak, on that far side. And look at this gap. Look at this right here. Hold it right there. Take a look at this distance that this puck can travel unobtrused. And that's a dangerous situation. Pastrnak's got all the time in the world to load up on that one time, and it's a very hard save for Drieger to get left to right.
The perfection line in action right there. The 21st goal of the season for David Pastrnak. Let's have a look at the Verizon shot chart. 9 shots for the Kraken in that second period. How do they get something from this game?
Start blocking some more shots, try to generate a little bit more offense. We talked in the pregame show about getting out of the zone clean and then getting into the opposing zone clean, setting up offensively. Have seen a little bit of that. I do like it. It was better in the second period than it was in the first, but you have got to generate more offensive opportunities, and you do that by just being quick and efficient. It doesn't have to be pretty. Easy for me to say. It doesn't have to be pretty. It just has to be efficient.
Even easier for you to say. I tell you, the Kraken, Ben,
you're the guy that had a month off.
Yeah, like Nick Gismondi's vocal cords are quitting on us right now. Well, for that second goal, a little bit of misfortune for the Kraken. Taylor Hall getting it. Nick Gismondi is off to get some new teeth. Angie Mentick is back here in a moment with Cale Flurry.
TD Garden, and the Bruins lead it 2-0. After 2 periods. Angie Mentick here at the Ford Sports Desk. You know, there were just so many storylines heading into tonight's game with the Bruins. We spoke with Ryan Donato after the first period, who made his return to Boston. And then you have brothers Cale and Hayden Fleury playing together for the first time in the NHL. We heard from their proud parents earlier, and now Arjen Mueller catches up with Cale.
Well, Cale, coming into the game, zone entries and exits were a big point of emphasis. How would you say the team is doing up to this point?
I think it's been pretty good. We have pretty good support in D zone on our breakouts, and it's been working well for us working as a 5-man unit. And I think the same thing on the entries.
We've seen Boston score on the power play. What needs to tighten up defensively?
I mean, they've got guys that can really shoot the puck, so I think sometimes it just comes down to getting a block.
Lastly, it's the first time that we are seeing you play alongside your brother. I'm sure that it is special, but how do you guys feed off each other out there?
Yeah, it's pretty cool. Playing with him, obviously, first time I've done that in a while. I think it's just we've known each other whole lives. We kind of know each other plays, so it just helps out with that.
Were you able to settle the nerves going out there early on?
Yeah. I try not to get too nervous out there.
Well, go enjoy the third. Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh, it is such a good story. I'm so happy for their parents. I know they're just absolutely bursting tonight. Hopefully they can come back in this game. Wondering where you are cheering on the Kraken tonight. Sean sends this one in, and apparently Santa sent him to see the Kraken there in Boston. That's really cool of Santa. And Andy there as well. Keep those photos coming, and we will try to get them on the broadcast. Here is a look at your second period
Supermo moments. Those are your McDelivery Supermo moments. Some anger spilling over, perhaps Kraken players frustrated that they have to change all of their All-Star reservations now because of the rescheduled game tomorrow against the Islanders. David Pasternak with the goal, his 21st of the season, and Taylor Hall collecting his 10th. We are back after this.
Power plays, a big story tonight. Pasternak has the goal for the Bruins. The Kraken have had five tonight, only five power play shots, and they did have a 5-on-3. Let's take a look at tonight's All-State mayhem moment, JT. A big dust up here.
Yeah, don't necessarily like the cross check off of the draw to Yanni Gord. Getting a little bit of a wrestling match, a tussle there. You know, good for Lauzon and for Forbert that this was considered a roughing and not an actual fight, because the secondary altercation did happen between those two. You're going to see him down on the ice. But that's the lucky part. There wouldn't be a second altercation there in that corner. But that could set up for an interesting third period here.
Shots are even at 18 as we get set for this third period. Tonight from Boston, tomorrow night UBS Arena, Elmont, New York. In the shadows of Belmont Park, the brand new barn for the New York Islanders. We hit the air with Kraken pregame, presented by Coors Light at 3:30 Pacific. The Kraken will send out Alexander Wennberg to take this opening faceoff of this third period, opposed by Boston's Tomáš Nosek, John Forslund, JT Brown, Jen Mueller, supported as always by a great crew from our side of things on Root Sports and also here at the Garden. As we peer down and get ready, we'll see if the Kraken have a comeback in them tonight. They started this road trip with an overtime win in Pittsburgh on Thursday. A gut-wrenching loss against the Rangers in the final seconds in regulation on Sunday afternoon, and now this. Play comes to a halt as it's sent deep in the zone. 9 seconds gone in this third period. Faceoff will be outside the blue line on the offside. Donskoy taps it back for Jeremy Lauzon. Here's Ryan Donato. The two ex-Bruins on the ice for Seattle. The Bruins get it out. Slammed in off the stick of Ullmark by Dunn. Mike Riley back on it. He'll move it across. Reset. David Pasternak bottled up by Ryan Donato. You see it come back in Boston territory. Riley sent back in. Onside for Donskoy. A reset. Donato. Now Wennberg. He's hounded by Hall. Donskoy shot, scores! Finally, Jonas Donskoy finds the cash. 19-18 left in this third period. The Kraken cut the lead in half.
Well, that's how you want to start the third period. Boston's not able to get the puck out of the zone. It's a good play right here. They all attract right onto Wennberg. Donskoy is going to find the puck. Seeing eye shot. There's a lot of traffic and people in the lane. And this is one where, you know what, you just feel it. It's going to go in eventually. He keeps getting the opportunities. It's going to turn around for him. And that's a seeing eye shot. You know that had to feel good for Jonas Donskoy.
His first goal in 44 games. His first as a Seattle Kraken. And he has just come to work each and every day. Marchand will knock it down. It goes wide of Chris Drieger. McAvoy spins it off a stick off Craig Smith. He'll hunt it down. McAvoy looks it over to the outside. Marchand sealed off on the short side by Drieger. From the corner and out, it's Jordan Eberle. Played along, kicking it to his stick is Jared McCann. He'll get it deep. He'll go in hard on the forecheck. He'll shove Marchand. Forbert to the outside. There's Lazar. He retrieves the puck for Patrice Bergeron, who feathers back in the zone. Drieger out to get it. This is Hayden Fleury, hit hard by Lazar. Coyle moved to the outside. Marchand still out there, drags it, run into by Yarncroak. And it's toe dragged along here by Yanni Gord. Mason Appleton, Gord again. Yarncroak for the front. Here comes Cale Fleury shifting in. Yanni Gord
Out in front of Chance Allmark says no. What an opportunity for Kelly Yarncroke.
Seattle showing signs of life early in the third period. A good play by Yanni Gourde. Finds Yarncroke right in the slot there. Isn't able to get a full hard shot on that, but is able to get it towards the net with traffic out in front. Allmark is able to be there for the save.
The period is not 2 minutes old. Excellent start for Seattle. The goal by Jonas Donskoy. That scoring chance by Yarncroke. Kiki. Blackwell and Sheehan come out. EQC scoring summary, 42 seconds in. Donskoy is first from Donato. And Wenberg, Giordano now, moves it in. Out of the corner, Riley Sheehan. Matt Grizzlick, forecheck by Blackwell. Here's Charlie Coyle. The Kraken cut it off. Blackwell has the puck, he'll cut. Shot taken, turned out, rebound. Stopped again by Allmark. Blackwell taken down in a hard way. They play on. Giordano drifts it in. Grizzlick in control. Voracek double teamed on the way out. Morgan Geeky for Seattle. Larson this way for Giordano. He'll dust it off. Intentionally off the boards, off the back of the cage. Brandon Carlo under duress. Broken up by Geeky, then taken out by Curtis Lazar. He'll float it through center. Charlie Coyle goes off in a change. He'll dump it in. Mark Giordano. Good look at him. 38-year-old captain of the Kraken out to center. Off the stick of McAvoy. Mike Riley flushed out by Donskoy. Hassled on the way out. Good work by 72. Now McAvoy hinges back out to the center zone. He'll shoot in. All the way around. Anton Bleed. Stephen Fogarty to the corner. Guarded by Wenberg to the point. Riley. Now McAvoy. He'll survey. Good stick by Wenberg. And the Kraken are back out. Jonas Donskoy has open ice. He'll cross the line, lay it out in front for Donato, forked wide as he was taken down. Charlie McAvoy for Mike Riley. He'll gain center off a glass support. A handle for Drieger to an open flank. Fleury readies for a hit. Wenberg helps out the D. Seattle's back out. Alex Wenberg in control. At his side, Yarncroke. The Kraken are offside.
Seattle's been good early on in this period. A good chance from Blackwell right there. Sheehan driving the net. Pays a little bit of a price there.
Yanni Gourde and his group come out. Gourde, Appleton, Yarncroke. Hayden Fleury giving a shove, taken down by Pasternak, who has the puck. David Pasternak greeted there, comes out. Forbert takes it away from Appleton. Wedged by Hall, not deep. Carried in offside by Nosek. Another stoppage. Another product of the real Harvard, Colin Blackwell. And an update, they came all the way back. Teddy Donato and the Crimson, 5-3 over BC. They were down 2-0 early. If I recall correctly now, Fleury out to center. Comes all the way back in. Forbert hounded by Appleton. Taylor Hall has a goal tonight. Yarncroke knocks it down. Stick over his shoulder. That's illegal. We get a face-off. 15:43 left.
You didn't have to go there and say the real Harvard.
I just wanted to. I just it'd been easy tonight.
Harvard would have sufficed. It would have been okay. Just Harvard.
Well, I did check the rankings, and Duluth is number 8.
A little too high.
Really? Wow. Goes across now. Out in front, Drieger hangs on. With disturbance here as Giordano is taken off it out in front, and Drieger holds his territory.
Good little shot right in front. You have Giordano going to the net, falls down. Marchand is right there trying to get that rebound. Drieger's all over it. But when it comes to the rankings, you want the low number like Gulfs, right?
Right.
That's exactly right. And you know, in the radio booth, we have the Boston flavor, too. Dave Tomlinson doing a fine job alongside Everett Fitzhugh, who's been taking in all the delicacies in all these towns. But Tomlinson was the MVP for Boston University in the early 90s in the Beanpot, which starts next week. Historic tournament here between Boston College, BU, Harvard, and Northeastern. Puck goes out of play, and a penalty is called here. Just about 5 minutes gone in this third period.
Boston 63, minor penalty interference.
Brad Marchand is guilty.
Going in for the play there, just hits Appleton, doesn't have the puck. It's going to be an interference call. He's reaching for it. Appleton doesn't quite get it. Riley's the one who takes that puck, sends it up over the glass. That's going to be the interference call on Marchand. You got a sixth opportunity here if you're Seattle.
Yep, number six. And hopefully for Seattle, it's a lucky number. Muckleshoot Casino Power Play. Take the luck from the casino, take it to the ice. We'll see what happens here. They only have had five power play shots in the five opportunities thus far. Johansson, Eberle, Yarncroke, McCann, Giordano. Forbert gets to it. He'll move it all the way around. Shot by Giordano off a stick off Lazar. Lazar out of the corner is hounded. Retrieval, Yarncroke, Giordano, shot taken, turned out by Ullmark, directed right to the corner. Eberle wins the battle, shoves it back for Giordano. He'll walk it, look it over, McCann across. Here's Eberle. He'll play it from the boards, he'll go deep. Johansson for McCann, hounded by Lazar. In front, Yarncroke, Eberle sends it back, held in by Giordano. Eberle thinks about it, thinks twice. The captain up top, Jordan Eberle in the circle. Deals it back for Giordano. Shot taken, tipped high off the glass, off Yarncroke. Out of play.
Well, it looks like they got the memo. They're getting pucks towards the net. Shots in. Even though it doesn't end up getting in on goal, it's the fact that they're trying to throw pucks in, a little bit less of too much passing, cross crease, trying to find the perfect play. Sometimes you just have to start getting pucks to the net and outnumbering them.
Good traffic out in front, simple play. We've been talking about it between periods, off air. Johansson, Eberle, Yarncroke, McCann, Giordano. Group of five for Dave Hackstall and the Kraken. Charlie Coyle. Off the draw. Dugout. Sent back Yarncroke. Giordano. Around the horn for Eberle. A shot taken just wide. Through some traffic. Giordano dangles away. Sets up McCann. Gets it back. Now Eberle. Giordano hammers one. Stopped by Ullmark. The rebound. Charlie Coyle. Pounded by Kelly Yarncroke. A retake. A reset. Here they come. McCann at the point. 43 seconds left in the power play. Good work by Coyle. He shoves down McCann. Kills time. Vince Dunn's on the ice now for Seattle, joined by Ryan Donato, Jonas Donskoy, Morgan Geeky, and Yanni Gord. This is Dunn. Donato through the middle. Marked by three. Anton Bleed is one of those. Donskoy has the Seattle goal. He'll move it for Geeky. Furthers back for Dunn. Dunn straight away. Morgan Geeky dangling that puck. Thinking about a seam pass. And now Dunn surveys up top. One-timer Gord, a slap pass doesn't work. And now it goes by Geeky out to center. Forced by Anton Bleed. 2 seconds left on the Boston kill. They get it done again. Seattle is 0-6. Bergeron cut off by Geeky. Seattle through center. Here's Yanni Gord. Donato for the front. It's defended by McAvoy. Geeky lays it along for Lauzon. His shot shielded by Ullmark. In play. Adam Larson at the point. He'll draw it in. Awaiting is Donato and Gord. Read defensively by Derek Forbert. And the Bruins are out. Here's Craig Smith pickpocketed by Geeky. Gord sends it back for Lauzon, who goes D to D with Adam Larson. 12:39 left. Regulation time here in Boston. 2-1, Bruins. Here comes Blackwell, pestered by Hall. All the way across for Larson.
His shot tipped in! Mason Appleton right on the spot! 12:30 left in regulation time. Seattle has tied it.
Seattle's had the advantage in shots this period. Another puck getting towards the net. Starts off with Blackwell, a good move to find the defenseman late, throwing it to the net. Might be looking like a double tip there off of Appleton and a Bruins defender as well into the back of the net. Appleton's got the first part, he celebrates. So you know it hit Appleton, it gets a second bounce right there off of McAvoy and into the back of the net.
Well, Butch Cassidy has had enough, the Boston coach. He's going to call a timeout and just lightly discuss this with his team. So, a 2-0 lead has evaporated. And a new story here in Boston. We'll take a look at the reworked schedule for the Kraken. After the All-Star break, the Islanders tomorrow, then Arizona on the 9th, at Anaheim on the 11th, Toronto on the 14th, a road trip, Winnipeg, Calgary, Vancouver, Islanders again, the Bruins come in, and the Sharks. So no doubleheaders. We kidded about that with all these postponements. But that is a lot of play, rest, and play. That's it. There won't be a lot of time to practice. Now it's played out to center. Comes all the way down. They call for icing. Omark handles it. No icing. Mason Appleton. Game-tying goal in this third period. Wenberg, Donskoy, Donato. Squirts out to Pasternak, and now coming back to it is Dunn. Across for Lauzon. Donato, nice cut in half by Nosek. Hall tags up, he gets onside, they play on. This is Vince Dunn hinging out through the center zone. Nice play by Donato. He takes a hit, stays with it. Forbert knocking him down. Grizzlick, Pasternak. Little Keystone Cops action here, and it comes back out to center. Laid across for Mark Giordano. He'll shoot in and back of Allmark and all the way around. 11:42 left in this third period. Grizzlick. Wedged out by Lazar. Overskated by Coyle. Taken back by Eberle. Here's Larson. Adam Larson. Shadowed by Lazar. Giordano. Finds the handle. A quick up off the stick of McCann. Coyle gave it away. Seattle will settle it down. They have just tied the game. It was off a stick. It deflects out of play. We get a stoppage. 11 minutes, 18 seconds left to go in regulation time. A new story. Two celebrations. The first as a Kraken for Jonas Donskoy. What a feeling. Then Mason Appleton, a tip out in front. 2-2 the count in Beantown. It's Northwest Chevy Silverado drive to the net.
It's going to be both Seattle Kraken goals. The first by Donskoy is able to find an opening through the traffic. Gets the top glove goal, and then Larson throwing it to the net. You have Appleton driving out in front, able to get a tip on it, pass the goaltender, and that's a different story from the first two periods, and it's tied 2-2.
Donskoy's goal at 42 seconds. Appleton's at 7:30. Larson, the only helper on the goal by Appleton. Lazar, shot taken, sealed off by Drieger. No rebound.
Drieger hasn't been tested much in this third period. He's going to have to stay strong just like this, able to swallow up the puck, no rebounds. That's what you need out of Drieger right now going into the last half.
Coyle, Lazar, and DeBrusk for Bruce Cassidy. Dave Hakstol has the Gord line out. He wins it back. Giordano with Larson, Yarncroke, and Appleton, the bookends for Yanni Gord. Now Giordano. Stretches out the ice. Chipped in the zone by Appleton. Mike Riley is on it. We play it to the line. Taken back by Larson. Gord snaps it across.
Long reach of Mike Riley got to it. It ricochets around off Yarncroke, collected by Charlie Coyle. He'll send it in. Giordano has some time. Larson, Gord, goes back out. Backtracking, Lazar taken down by Donskoy. See it come back in the Seattle zone, reversed by Larson for Giordano. Little heat from Oscar Steen. The jam along the board. Steen has it for Boston. Anton Blade out in front. Good play by Wenberg on Fogarty. Out of the corner. Stephen Fogarty had the chance, and now Donato crunched by Anton Blade. McAvoy. Forbert. Fogarty. Delays. Off the pad of Drieger. To the corner, a heavy hit by Blade on Donato, and a penalty will be called. McAvoy's got it. He'll send it in. It's going against Seattle. Ullmark's on the bench. McAvoy moved across. Forbert to the outside. He gets it back. It goes off bodies. Still available. And it's frozen by Giordano. Tripping call. And we'll tell you about it when we come back. 9:32 left in regulation time. The penalty is on Seattle's Mark Giordano.
Things were getting a little bit crazy in the defensive zone for Seattle. Steen going for the puck. You see Giordano just take the legs out.
McAvoy, Marchand. Bergeron, a wedge off a body blocked by Yarncroke. Boston back to work on the power play. David Pastrnak has a power play goal for them tonight. His shot goes in off Drieger. David Pastrnak from the far flank with Taylor Hall out in front, but it pinballs in. It's a power play goal again, and the Bruins go back up by one.
Well, this is an interesting one here. It ends up getting over to Pastrnak. I don't know if that was going wide in the air. It ends up going off the glove of Drieger and into the net. It's almost one of those plays trying to send it to the backside. Get a good look at it there. Yeah, it goes off the glove and in of Drieger. That's a tough goal after battling back. Seattle still has time, and there's still work to do now.
Oh, man. Okay, along the boards now. Fogarty sends it in. Hayden Fleury hit by Anton Blade. Cale Fleury moves it to the wall. He's punished by Oscar Steen, and now McCann for Hayden. Hayden Fleury at the line moves it ahead. It's offside. 8:51 left in regulation time. 22nd goal of the season for David Pastrnak, his second tonight. McCann, Johansson, Eberle for Seattle. In the Boston zone, McAvoy dumps it out. Cale Fleury, Hayden Fleury, turning stick of Jared McCann. Broken up by DeBrusk.
Boston goal.
Seattle gets back onside.
Scored on the power play by number 88, David.
Now reset for the Kraken. Done. McCann this way. Marcus Johansson, he's in the zone. He'll drag it. He lost it. It was defended by McAvoy. Lazar moves in. Played along the boards by Jake DeBrusk. His shot tipped wide by Lazar. Follow-up chance. Angles off a body from Matt Grizzlick. And now Jordan Eberle deals it back for Vince Dunn. Just about 12 minutes gone in this third period. 3-2 Boston. This is DeBrusk. He'll take it in on Wenberg. He'll center one off a stick. It went off Dunn. Lozon had it. He lost it. He goes down, and Drieger manages the game.
Another look at this goal from the Bruins. A high angle. We get here. Don't get the puck out. Bad things end up happening. Pastrnak from an off angle is able to throw that one towards the net, off the glove and in. Seattle did have an opportunity, though, to get that puck down 200 feet.
Pastrnak is second tonight, as we said, 22nd goal of the season. Patrice Bergeron, Brad Marchand, the assist. So
They haven't played much at 5-on-5, the perfection line, but it was perfect on the power play. And we catalog those three in our open. One-timer Fandon for the hat trick. 88. Pasternak knocks it down. It comes back out. Donskoy, Donato. This way, Giordano. A centering feed off a stick off McAvoy. Deferred out by Pasternak. Nosek tries to get it out for Boston. He does. Steered out by Pasternak again. 7:20 on the clock. Kraken down by one. Kraken and the New York Islanders to close out the trip tomorrow. We start with Kraken pregame at 3:30. It comes in on Trigger. We play it along for Giordano. Wennberg will cut back in his own zone. Larson fumbles a pass. Yarncroak is there, though, and they reorganize it. Giordano angles off the boards for Kelly Yarncroak. He lost it. Marchand hits the line. Takes it in. The drop pass for Bergeron is broken up. Carried out by Yarncroak, supported by Gord. Good back checking by Craig Smith. Smith along the wall, broken up. Gord for Dunn. Vince Dunn, Yanni Gord at the line. The pass broken up by Grizzlick. He'll get it back. He'll move it all the way around. Here comes Lauzon. Jeremy Lauzon spins off Derek Forbert. Sends it deeper for Mason Appleton, who has a goal tonight. Here's Dunn again. Along the boards, Appleton for Gord. Side of the goal defended by Grizzlick and also Smith. And it comes back for Dunn. Shot taken. Tip knocked down just wide. Yanni Gord out in front. Gord now. Lauzon's cruising. Gord's calling for it. Here it comes. Blocked by Grizzlick. Knocked down. Controlled. Marchand skates out. Rubbed out by Lauzon. Marchand really gets after it with Lauzon at the bench.
Let him go.
Yes. Out to center. Broken up. Everly over the line. McCann dangles. His shot goes wide off Brandon Carlo. Johansson, great work. Cale Fleury. McCann's shot goes high. It's tipped out of play. We get a stoppage. 5 minutes. 35 seconds left in regulation time. David Pasternak from well out off the catching minute in as we go down the stretch here in Boston. A flashback for Jeremy Lauzon. And he is tonight's Sametra teammates. Some of his action originally number 79 with the Boston Bruins. A little tussle there with Matthew Tkachuk, first career goal. And here he is with an ex-teammate. Marchy, as they call him. Get out of here, and he did.
Said he can be a frustrating player to play against at Marchand. You see it there, giving him a little extra shove. But you like to see that. No friends out there.
Face off in the Boston zone. Kraken down by one, late stages. TD Garden, John, JT, Jen. Donato clipped. They play on. Giordano sends it in all the way around. Brandon Carlo saddled up by Morgan Geeky. Nosek, good play. Grizzlick skated out by Oscar Steen. They'll move it deep in the zone. Larson, forechecked a bit by DeBrusk. Gloved down by Geeky. And Jonas Donskoy heels back in his own zone. Looks around. Giordano. Geeky for Donskoy. Good sweep check by Coyle. Lazar. Coyle with a shot. It sizzles off the glass in play. Moved deeper in the zone for Charlie Coyle. Curtis Lazar stopping and starting. Hounded by Larson. Donskoy right up the gut. Gets it out. McAvoy's on his horse. He fumbles the dump out. Johansson sends it all the way around for McCann. Fresh on a change, supported by Eberle. Eberle broken up by Marchand. He'll skate out. Brad Marchand. Picked up again by Jeremy Lauzon. Smith forks it to himself out in front off Dunn. Kraken take it back. Lauzon out of the corner, guarded by Marchand. Eberle pressured by Riley. Brad Marchand, high slot. Fiddles, diddles, shoots. It goes off sticks. It went off McCann. Maybe Dunn too. And it goes out of play.
I think you have to know too the way Boston's played after that timeout that they've taken after Seattle's second goal. Boston's had the majority of the pressure. You look at the coach right here.
You don't know exactly what was said, but I'm sure something along the lines of you're better than this. You got to be able to take this game back over with, and they've done so far after that timeout. It's been pretty much all Boston.
Take a look at those out-of-town scores. Happy birthday to Miles Shaber, 11 years old today, the son of our great producer, Ryan Shaber, who gets to work again tomorrow. But he's watching the game tonight. Great family. Great Kraken fans. It's sent in. They've been brainwashed. Now Nosek broken up. Gord to the outside. Larson moves it back. Under 4 minutes left. Lozon moves it by Yarncroak. All the way in. Riley wins the race to the dot. So it's icing. And we take it back. So the New York Islanders, boy, JT, a lot of people picked the Islanders to go all the way to the Stanley Cup final. I would have to say I thought so too, but COVID hit them hard, some injuries. They just haven't been able to get it going. They started almost 2 months, basically 2 months on the season on the road. So they have a new building. They're well coached. It'll be a tough game tomorrow night to close out the trip. Shot taken, leaks through Drieger from Nosek. Cycled out by Hall. Caught by Chris Drieger, no further play.
Drieger's just going to be able to get the toe of the skate on that puck. Just trickles wide right there. But yes, you can say about the Islanders, it's tough to play that many games on the road.
Yeah.
You go back home and then you have to go right onto the road again with no games at home. You can see why, you know, some of the struggles happen for that team.
And it's hard to play that many at home too, right? People would say, hey, nice long home stands. Yeah, I don't know. Those aren't easy. Comes out to center. Comes off the stick of Coyle. Cale Fleury. A shoot in by Jonas Donskoy. Carlo on the way around. Hayden Fleury moving down the wall on Steen. Brandon Carlo. 3:10 left in regulation time here at TD Garden. Bleed dumps it out. Hayden Fleury takes it all the way back. Cale Fleury starts from his own zone. His first game as a Kraken. He's been solid. Through center, goes off the stick of Donskoy. Charlie McAvoy all the way around. There's Craig Smith, a little steer. They get it back in. This is icing. 2:47 left. So this gives Dave Hakstol a chance to change. Boston cannot because of the icing. As you see, the Bruins will make their only appearance in the Emerald City on February 24th. Vince Dunn's coming off. No, he's staying out. Yes, he's coming off. You just never know, do you? That would have been too many men on the ice. Thank goodness they cleaned that one up. Okay, Gord, Johansson, Eberle, McCann, and Giordano will keep an eye on Drieger. One back, a steal. Easily going down Marchand. They play on. Unpaid officials get all riled up. It's played to the boards now. Johansson sends it back. Giordano, 2:30 left. Shots even, 26. Scores not. Boston by one. Down and out for Gord. He's in. There goes Drieger. Six out. Six out for Seattle. Six skaters now. McCann out of the corner. Guarded by McAvoy. Here's Dunn. Around the clock for Gord. Vince Dunn. McCann hammers one. Stopped by Ullmark. It deflects to the boards. Dunn. Johansson to the outskirts again for McCann. He'll gather in. Johansson in back of the goal. Looks out in front. Thinks twice. McCann. Here's Dunn cruising. Eberle swings it off a body. Off Grizzlick. Johansson separated from the puck by Bergeron. He'll clear it. It'll deflect out of play. No penalty. 1:48 left.
Got McCann setting up in a shooter position. It's where you want. Right there goes off that right shoulder of Ullmark. A really good shot for McCann. That's a player they're looking to set up here on this 6-on-5.
So Chris is on the bench. Seattle calls their timeout. Boston burned theirs earlier. The best bars are hockey bars, and all your Kraken favorites are part of the Anchor Alliance. Broadcasting every game, these local watering holes are the place for Kraken fans to cheer the team to victory with a brew in hand. Visit bit.ly/anchoralliance to find your new favorite bar. The family of Ryan Donato in large numbers in a beautiful suite here at the Garden. And we pointed out his father, Ted, coaching tonight, Harvard. He was a very good Boston Bruin, Teddy Donato. Final score, Harvard defeats Boston College 6-3. Six skaters on the ice for Seattle. Gord, Yarncroke, Geberle, Johansson, McCann, and Dunn. 1:48 on the clock. Faceoff wins Seattle. Dunn, McCann, shot taken, tipped wide off Forbert. He checks out his stick, it's okay. Forbert will get to it, move it off the boards and out. Seattle tags up. Johnny Gord awaiting. Tough pass to handle as it's deflected. Coyle taken down by Everly. 1:25 left. Dunn. Fans on the shoot in because of a broken stick. It squirts out. Everly shot angled. Forbert. Omar. Get it done. 1:18 left. Charlie Coyle goes at Jordan Everly.
Not able to get this puck out. It ends up getting over to Everly, gets that shot in. Charlie Coyle wasn't up. He was a little bit upset with that little push from behind when there was the battle along the boards. Coyle went down. It was Everly who pushed him down in that situation. But again, smartly enough, you don't take a penalty in that situation. Even though he's going over there trying to get you into something, Everly does the right thing, kind of skates away and just allows it to be.
Bergeron wins the draw. McAvoy attempts to get possession. 1:13 on the clock. Nosek will hustle for Boston. Hounded by McCann. They go to the corner. Six attackers for the Kraken. Here's Giordano. This way for Gord. On and off his stick. He'll get to it. Everly in back of the goal. To the outside for Yanni Gord. One-timer. Giordano deflects a shot just wide. McCann had a yawning cage. It appeared and it comes out. 48 seconds left. Giordano draws it away from Curtis Lazar. Yanni Gord sends it back. The Kraken have 38 seconds left to work with here in Boston. Played along the boards. Forged in by Gord. Forbert gets to it. A half minute left. Wide open is Brandon Carlo. Moved out to Nosek. It's taken back by Vince Dunn. Final push for Seattle. Dunn moved along. Chipped in the zone by Gord. 13 seconds left. Carlo. Donato's on him. They go to the wall. 9 seconds left. Still battle. It comes out. Forbert in back of the goal. McCann's got it. 3 seconds on the clock. Forbert seals them off. They go to the corner. That's all. Jared McCann had a brilliant opportunity, JT, right here.
Really good chance. A one-timer from up top. Kicks right off the pad. Ulmer diving back, trying to make the save. A good shot with traffic. Ends up bouncing right out to McCann. You got to get this shot off really quickly. Just ends up missing the net, but that close to tying the game at the end with the 6-on-5.
Another tough one on this road trip that ends tomorrow night against the New York Islanders. Final count here in Boston. The Bruins 3, the Kraken 2. Once again, Ross and Nick.